years, myself Silke. In this short tutorial, Silke's tools present determination of the different parts of horizontal curve. Like in this section, we learn the determination of the curve length, the chord length, the tangent length, the midordinate, apex distance, and the radius when chord and midordinate are known, and something stretch. Remember, this is for horizontal circular curve. Let's say if we consider a horizontal curve like in this form, the deflection angle is 100 degree and say the radius of the curve is 500 feet. Keep in mind the deflection angle of a circular curve and its central angle are always the same. And let's say we are asked to find the curve length, the curve chord length, the tangent length, midordinate, and apex distance. The radius of the curve and the deflection angle of the curve are just enough to calculate all these 5 unknown parts of the curve. So I'll just come straight into solutions. For the solution, I just want to create a new page. Let's say solution. And the first thing I want to calculate is say just the tangent length. Remember, the tangent length is just the distance between the tangent point of the curve and the intersection point of the curve. And there is always a plug-in check-in formula for this approach. Like r times tangent half of the deflection angle will be just the tangent length of the curve. We will not derive all the formulas because it will take much time and the video will be a little longer. So we will just do plug-in check-in. Like the tangent length equals, the radius is known, which is 500 feet. So 500 times tangent of half deflection angle. The deflection angle is just 100. So the half will be just 500. So tangent of 500. Do some maths, we'll get of course 595.876 feet. So this is just the tangent length. And secondly, let me calculate just the chord length of the curve. Remember, the chord length is just the distance between two curve point or two tangent point of the curve. For chord length calculation, there is always a nice plug-in check-in formula like 2r times sine of half of the deflection angle. So let's do some plug-in check-in like L equals 2 times r is known, 500, times sine of 500. Because the deflection angle is just half over here. And this is 100, so the half will be 500. Do some maths, we'll get of course 766.04 as the chord length of the given curve. And next, let me just calculate the curve length. And for the curve length, we have a nice formula over here. Pi r times deflection angle times 180. To calculate the curve length, let's do some plug-in check-in in this formula. Like L equals pi is known, the radius is known, 500. Times the angle is known, 100 divided by 180, we'll get of course L equals, or the curve length equals 872.67 feet. And this is it. And next, let me calculate the midordinate. Remember, the midordinate or the worst sign is just the distance between the center of the chord to the center of the curve, like in this form. And again, we'll use a nice plug-in check-in formula. Like r times 1 minus cos half of the deflection angle, and we'll do some plug-in check-in like h equals, the r is known again, 500, times 1 minus cos of 500, and this is of course just 178.6. And next, let me just calculate the apex distance. Remember, the apex distance is just the distance from the apex point to the intersection point. And for this approach, we'll use the same formula, like r times secant of the half of the deflection angle minus 1. Let's do some plug-in check-in. Like the radius is again known, 500 times secant of 500, because 100 is deflection angle, its half is 500 minus 1. Do some maths or use your calculator, we'll get of course the apex distance is 277.86 feet, right? Remember, secant is just 1 over cos. Don't confuse over here. And lastly, let me just say, if we have to find the radius of curve and some things are known, like the chord is known, right? It is just 1000 and the midordinate is known, 100 meter. If the chord is 1000 and the midordinate is 100, then what's the radius of the curve? Alright, and there is just a nice plugin chicken formula derived from the Pythagorean theorem, like a square plus h square divided by 2h. Here, h just represent the half of the card, okay? And h is known, right? So we'll do some plugin checking, like the curve radius equals a square. A is just the half of the card. So it's 500 square plus h square, h is 100. So 100 square divided by 2 times h. We'll get, of course, the radius equals 1300 meter, right? So this is it. We learned how to determine or just find different parts of a curve. Remember, this is just a circular curve, okay? I'll bring another video to explain different things about curve and its setting out. So wait for that and like the video and just press the subscribe button. Thank you, viewers, for watching. See you next time. Wassalam.